Hi all. The next topic in this course is matrix. How we can represent the linear equation using a matrix representation. That's what we are going to see. So first of all, you have to look at the general form of system of linear equations. So we can write the set of linear equations like this: a11x1 plus a12x2 plus a etc. a1n xn is equal to b1
system of linear
and
equations.
So on. We have m equations over here. The last equation a1x1 plus am2x2 plus etc. mn
system of linear equations
b.
are nothing but
so
they
have
are
m equations
of linear equations,
and it can be
and
converted in the form of
have
matrix
some common
like this.
Properties or they are
we have to take
to
all the
other.
Coefficient matrices,
those kind of
all the coefficients and form the matrix.
System
so
of
in the first
linear
matrix
equations.
I
some
have a11, a12, a13, etc. a1n. So I have m
equations.
Rows over here.
So let's see
m
an
equations,
example.
There exist.
We have
and
some
it is represented as a matrix multiplication.
Products
and this coefficient matrix is multiplied
so
with the
variable I have
matrix.
Taken the
variable matrix is represented in a vector form or in
the
column vector form x1, x2, etc. xn. Is equal to the right hand side of the equation b1, b2, b3, etc. bm. And let's check whether it satisfies the matrix multiplication constraints. The first matrix, the coefficient matrix has the dimension m by n. It has m rows and n columns. And the second matrix have n rows since n variables are there and one column. So it satisfies the multiplication constraint. Like the first matrix have n columns and the second matrix have n rows. And the result will be m by 1 matrix. So that b1, b2, etc. b1, bm is an m by 1 matrix. So this is how we represent a linear equation in matrix form. Then the vector representation, for example, we can take the these two equations, 2x1 plus 3x2 equal to 1, and the next equation is 5x1 plus x2 is equal to 3. And how we represent, we take out the coefficients from these equations and frame the coefficient matrix. So the first one is 2, 3, first row is 2, 3 corresponding to the coefficients of the first equation. And the second row is 5, 1 corresponding to the coefficients of the second equation. In multiplied with x1, x2 is equal to 1, 3, that is the right hand side. So we can represent it like this. This is a simple example. Then the matrices can be used to compactly represent the system of linear equations. And these representations are heavily used in machine learning. And there are some vector representations like row vector, column vector, and reshaping of the matrix. Row vector is nothing but it looks like this. It has only one row and many columns. Okay. Then the column vector is looks like something like this. It has many rows but one column. That is column vector. So this is the common vector representation we use in machine learning. So when we talk about vectors, vectors always represents a column vector or column matrix. And the other term is reshaping and resizing the matrix. Reshaping the matrix means the shape or the dimension can be changed. Suppose we have a matrix like this, a two-dimensional matrix with the two rows and three columns. I can convert it into a column matrix like this. Okay, it has six elements, so this column matrix will have six elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, this is reshaping. I change the dimension. I change from 2 by 3 to 6 by 1. That is reshaping. In some cases, we need the reshaping of the matrix. And the resizing is something different, that increases or decreases the size of the matrix. So if the matrix can contain 6 elements, I can resize it into 20 sized matrix, something like that. Okay, so these are the basic terminologies we use with the matrix operations. And basic matrix operations are addition, multiplication. Then addition, when we try to add two matrices, the constraint is these two matrices should be of the same size. If the first one is m by n, the second one should also be m by n. And assume this is matrix A and this is matrix B, and we try to add these two matrices. What happens is the corresponding elements will be added. Here the first row first column element and first row first column element are getting added. So 2 plus 1 will give you 3. And similarly, first row second column, first row second column, 3 plus 2, and the result will be 5. So similar. And again, we can write it in generalized form like this. The first row, first matrix represents A11, A12, etc., A1n. So m rows are there, and the second matrix B is represented like this. And the corresponding elements are getting added, A11 plus B11, A12 plus B12, like that. Okay, this is the general representation of matrix addition. Then the matrix multiplication. So there is a constraint like this. The number of columns in the first matrix should be equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. So only if the condition is satisfied, then only we can multiply these two matrices. So the matrices are A and B, and if I want to multiply this, the size or the dimension should be like this, and the resulting matrix C will have the dimension like m by n. So let's take this example. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 3, 2, 1. B is equal to 0, 2, 1, minus 1, 0, 1. Okay, so the size is 2 by 3, and this is 3 by 2. So it is multiplication is possible. Here, this is 3, and this is also 3. And when we add, the resulting matrix will be 2 by 2 matrix. So this is how we get the matrix. So we take the first row and multiply it with the first column of the second operand, and we get the find the sum, we'll get the answer. And take the first row, multiply it with the second column, we'll get the second value over here. Okay, like that. So we already know those multiplications. Okay, then next property is multiplication is not commutative. That means if I multiply A with B, A with B, that is may not be equal to B into A. Okay, that may not be possible, or may not be true in all the cases. It may not be equal. A, B may not be equal to B, A. That means the matrix multiplication is not commutative. Then identity matrix. Identity matrix is equal to 1 actually. When we represent a 1 using a matrix, that is identity matrix. And when we consider an identity matrix, it's all diagonal elements are 1. All the diagonal elements are 1 and the other elements are zeros. Okay, only the diagonal elements are 1, others are zeros. So I3 means it is 3 by 3 matrix. So it's, of course, it is a square matrix. I4 means it is a 4 by 4 matrix. And IN means it is an N by N matrix. Okay. And this identity matrix has a special role in the matrix operations. Why? Because when we multiply a matrix with identity matrix, the result will be A itself. And if I multiply an identity matrix with A, that is also giving you A. Okay. Now, the properties of multiplication, matrix multiplication, it is not commutative. That means A into B not equal to B into A. And it is associative, then distributive. And the multiplication with the identity matrix is a special case. as we said, a into I is equal to I into a is equal to a. And associative means a into b into c is equal to a b into c, like that. Okay, so that is associativity. But when we consider the associativity, we should check the dimensions. The dimension should satisfy this condition, then only this associative property will exist. That is, the first matrix has m by n, and the second matrix has n by p, and the third matrix has p by q. Then only the multiplication happens. Then the distributive means we have four matrices A, B, C, and D. The dimensions are like this: m by n, m by n, n by p, and n by p. So distribution includes the matrix addition as well as multiplication. So A plus B into C is equal to AC in AC plus BC. Okay. Then A into C plus D is equal to AC plus AD. So they are equivalent. And make sure that this size dimensions are satisfied. Then multiply with identity matrix, it is like this: A into identity matrix equal to I into A equal to A. So when we multiply any matrix with an identity matrix, it will result in the same matrix itself. So one example is given here, you can check out this. Then the next one is the inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix is calculated like this: A inverse is equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. So whenever we calculate the inverse of a matrix, make sure that this determinant of A not equal to 0. And one more thing, for all matrices, so for some matrices, inverse may not exist. Okay. So if determinant of A is equal to 0, there will not be any inverse exist. Okay. So we can check the steps for finding the inverse in our next session. So thank you all.